Hi, this is Anne with SVG Cut File, and today I'm going to show you how to get your hand lettering into Cricut Design Space. And to do this, you really need to use something very high contrast, so like a black Sharpie and just a white piece of paper. All right, let's get started. So first I'm just going to draw my text. I'm not the greatest at hand lettering, but I'm doing my best. And it's a good idea to get it as clean as possible with your Sharpie before taking it into Cricut Design Space. So I'm just gonna kinda go over the letters a little bit to kinda clean them up, make them less jagged. Any little areas like this that are rough, or if you have a little piece sticking out, it's best to try to just get rid of it. All right, and I think that looks pretty good. Now, you can either take a picture with your phone or scan it. I'll just take a picture of it so I can show you that way, but I'm using my phone to record right now. So I wanted to tell you that if you take the picture, try to put your camera somewhere where you're only getting the white on each side. You don't want to include all this stuff out here. It just makes it a little bit harder to work with. Okay, so once you take the picture, you can just email it to yourself and then go from there. Okay, I've started up Cricut Design Space, and I'm just going to make the window a little bit bigger. And then we're going to start a new project, and then I'll come over here to the bottom left and choose Upload. And now I'll come over here to Upload Image, and I'll browse for it. And it's right here, it's a JPEG, and I'll open that. Now, whenever you do this, your image needs to be one of these formats. If it's not, you'll need to convert it with maybe an online image converter. Next, we'll select Simple. And the reason we're going for Simple is because we've got black against white. It should be pretty easy to do. If you have a lot of different colors or something like that, you'll want to go with one of these other options. First, I'm going to come up to the Select and Erase and click on this. And then I'll come down here to Advanced Options. I want to reduce my colors to 2 because I really should only end up with black and white. So we'll choose that. And this is looking so weird because it's so zoomed in. So I'm going to zoom out. That's up here in the upper right. And I'll click this a few times. And you can see we've got 2 colors now. We've got the gray and the black. Now we'll come up here to the Select and Erase tool and just click on that gray area. And you can see it's completely removed it. And now we'll come in here. There's some parts of your letters that have enclosures, and you'll need to click in each one of those too. And that's looking pretty good, so I'm going to hit Continue. I'm going to save this as a cut image, so I'll click on it to select it, and then I'll do Save. And here it is. I can click on this now and insert images. Now, this is going to come in really big, so I'm going to zoom out, which is right down here in the lower left. I'll hit the minus button a few times, and I'm going to make this quite a bit smaller by using the little arrows down here and just moving it in. Okay, and now we can go back to 100%. So right now I'm at 10.5 inches wide, so this is cuttable. Now I will mention that if we zoom in, we can kind of see some roughness, and we can get rid of that by drawing a shape and then choosing slice. So I'll show you how to do that. Here's a little node right out here. It shouldn't be here. I'm going to get on shapes and then I'll choose square. It'll put a square on my screen. I'll make it really small and move it over top of that shape. Then I'll select both by holding Shift and clicking on the text too, so you can see they're both highlighted over here. And then we can slice. And now we can just highlight all 3 of those and just delete them. We can also do that along the edges of our text. Let's get a shape. I'm going to choose a square again. And do the same thing, make it a little smaller and just put it right along the edge of this. I'll unlock it and make it really long and thin, and then I'll rotate it a little bit and get it right on the edge there, like that. Now the rectangle is already selected, and I'll also select that text again. I'll come over here, and at the bottom right, I'll click Slice. And now we can see some pieces that we can delete over here in the Layers palette. Let's hit Delete. And you can see it really smoothed it up here. Now, this is going to take quite some time to really clean this up and get it smooth. If you have image editing software, it's going to be a lot easier to get it to look a little smoother than this. In Photoshop, you can just erase it easily. Cricut Design Space doesn't really have the option of doing that. Also, Illustrator is going to make it much smoother too. So hopefully you have some other software to help you clean this up quite a bit more. Once you're done getting it cleaned up the way you like it, come up here to the upper right and choose Make It. And now it's ready to be cut. And we can just continue, then you'll choose your machine and all that stuff and your material size. And you can go ahead and cut it. Okay, if you like this video and you want to see more like it, just hit the subscribe button and the little bell, and you'll be notified every time a new video comes out. Thank you!